Hey, my name is Felipe and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about the TensorFlow Developer Certificate and how I passed the exam, how I prepared myself in order to get certified as a TensorFlow Developer. And the first thing I'm going to discuss is what the TensorFlow Developer Certificate is. And if you want me to give you a very, very quick and a very succinct definition, I can tell you that this is a certification provided by TensorFlow, which is one of the most important frameworks in order to do deep learning, and it certifies that you are able to build basic machine learning models using TensorFlow. That's what this certification is all about, and this is very, very, very important because this means you do not have to be an absolute expert in TensorFlow or in machine learning to get certified. This only means that you are able to build basic machine learning models. That's what this certification is about. Now, let's continue and let me tell you why you should consider being certified as a TensorFlow developer. To do so, I invite you to watch one of my previous videos where I explain exactly why I decided to take a few machine learning certifications. The TensorFlow developer is one of them. I consider that if you are looking for a job as a machine learning engineer, being certified, having some certifications, for example, the TensorFlow developer, for example, this one, this may help you get a job, right? It may help you get a job as a machine learning engineer, but if it doesn't help you, is not going to harm you either, right? That's basically what I consider regarding certifications in machine learning. Now let me give you some details regarding the exam, how the exam works. And in order to do so, let's review the candidate handbook, which is the official information regarding the exam, regarding the TensorFlow developer certificate and regarding how the exam works. The first thing you should know regarding this certification is that it's not free, but you will need to pay $100. So this is very, very important. You will need to pay this amount of money, $100, for every single attempt of taking this exam. So if you take the exam and you fail, if you want to take it again, you will need to pay $100 again. This is very, 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 very important. Now, let me show you something else. Let me give you more details regarding the exam. And in order to pass the exam duration is 5 hours long. You will have 5 hours in order to complete the exam. And in my case, when I took the exam, I had to solve 5 problems. So in my case, I had to solve 5 problems in 5 hours. Now, I have been reviewing this handbook and I didn't find any reference to the number of problems you will need to solve during the exam. So although I had to solve 5 problems, this may change for different candidates, right? This may change for different exams because I didn't have any reference regarding how many problems you will need to solve in the candidate handbook, which is the most important and the most official documentation regarding this certification. Now let's continue, and now let me show you a screenshot I took when I was starting with this exam, actually before I started with this exam, and this is something you will need to agree as well if you are going to take this certification, which is you will have to take this exam completely on your own without the help from anyone else, and also after the exam you will not discuss the questions with anyone else, and you acknowledge that if you violate these conditions, your certificate will be revoked, and also you could be banned from all future Google certification exams. So this is something very, very, very important, and remember, this means you have to do it completely on your own without the help from anyone else. And also, as you will not be able to discuss the questions with anyone after the exam, this is why you are not going to find the questions anywhere online, right? If you search for the questions, you are not going to find them because you are not allowed to discuss these questions after you take it. Otherwise, your certification will be revoked. So don't bother searching for the questions. You are not going to find them. Now let's continue. Although you have to take this exam completely on your own without the help help from anyone else. Let me show you something. If I go back to the TensorFlow Developer Certificate Candidate Handbook and I scroll down and I go to resource allowed during the exam, you can see it says you may use whatever learning resources you would normally use during your machine learning development work. This is the official information in the official handbook provided by TensorFlow, so this is official. And I don't know what you think, but I think this is a very broad statement, because learning resources you will normally use during your machine learning development work, this involves many things. I have been working in machine learning for years, and I can tell you that even today I use many learning resources in my machine learning development work. If we talk about learning resources, I think YouTube could be considered a learning resource. I consider Stack Overflow is another learning resource. Kaggle could be considered a learning resource. And I would say nowadays, ChatGPT could be considered a learning resource as well. I don't know what you think. You have to decide for yourself what are the learning resources you will normally use during your machine learning development work. But if you ask me, I think that's a very broad statement. I think this involves many different types of resources. As long as you are taking the exam completely on your own, without the help from anyone else, you can use all the learning resources you will normally use during your machine learning development work, which is amazing. Now let's continue. And now let me show you something else, which is also very important, is that you will need to use the PyCharm IDE during the exam, right? This is a PyCharm is a very popular IDE in order to work with Python, and this is required in order to take this exam. So my recommendation for you is, if you are not already familiar with PyCharm, please go get familiar right away. Go download this IDE and go use it in order to work in Python, in order to work in TensorFlow, in order to train some models, because this is going to be required by the time you take this exam. And the way it works is that you will need to install a plugin in PyCharm in order to take this exam, and everything is described here: how you need to set up the environment, how you need to download PyCharm, what's the specific version of Python you will need to install, and so on. So please take a look at this handbook, and please take a look at this exam environment section, and please take a look at everything you will need to set up in order to download PyCharm and in order to take the exam in PyCharm. And something else which is very important is that, although you will need to write some Python code in PyCharm in order to train the machine learning models using TensorFlow, the way the exam works is that you are going to be given a given data set, and you are going to train a machine learning model on that data set. But then once you train the model, you are going to submit the model, and you are going to be graded based on the performance of that model on another data set you have absolutely no access to. And this may sound a little confusing if you are not used to these type of tests, but just remember that you are going to be given a data set, and then you are going to train a model, but the way you are going to be evaluated, or the way you are going to be graded, is on this model, but on a completely different data set you have absolutely no access to, and you have absolutely no information regarding how that data set was built, right? That's the way it works. And now let me show you the resources I used in order to prepare myself to pass the exam. If I go back to the TensorFlow Developer official website, which is this one, and if I scroll down, you can say that at the end it says something like, if you do not have the skills, if you don't feel ready to take the exam, these are a couple of courses which are recommended in order to acquire the skills you need in order to pass the exam. And these two courses, one of them is provided by Coursera, one of them is in this platform, which is Coursera, and the other one is from Udacity. So these are the two courses which are recommended, and in my case, Although I already have a lot of experience in machine learning, I have been working in machine learning for a very long time, I decided to follow one of these courses anyway, so I got more familiar with the outline and also with the level of complexity, how hard it is, right? Because if these are the courses which are recommended in order to take the exam, then it's a very good idea to get more familiar with the complexity of these courses. Right, remember that if it's about learning a skill, you can learn a skill in a very, very superficial way, or you can go super, 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 super deep. And in order to get more familiar with how deep I should go with the machine learning skills, I said it was a very good idea to take one of these courses. And the way I follow the one I took is this one from Udacity. And the only reason for this is because this one is free and the other one from Coursera is not free. So this is the one I decided to take. Let me click here on learn for free so I can show you how this course looks like on the inside. Now let me click here and I'm going to this outline over here. These are all the different topics which are covered in this course. And you can see that you have an introduction to machine learning, and then it's about building an image classifier using CNNs, and then it's about time series forecasting and about NLP, which are exactly the topics which you need to get familiar with in order to take the exam and in order to pass the exam. There are many video lessons in this course, and also there are many, many exercises. And the exercises, oh, they are super, super, super useful to get some hands-on experience on building models with TensorFlow. So although I am already experienced, I was already experienced with machine learning and TensorFlow before taking the exam, I found this course was very, very helpful in order to get more familiar with the outline and in order to get more familiar with exactly how deep I should go when training these machine learning models. So this is the main resource I used when I was preparing myself to pass this exam. And although I had some prior experience with machine learning and TensorFlow, and I had been working with machine learning for years, I can tell you that this course is very, very well structured and it's very well made, and it's an amazing resource to anyone who is trying to prepare himself or herself to pass this exam. So even if you are a complete beginner in machine learning and TensorFlow, I will say this course is amazing. I will say this is the main resource I will recommend you in order to prepare yourself for this exam. And something else is that, remember, you are going to be graded not on the code itself, but on the performance on the model you trained on another dataset you are not going to have access to. And this type of grading system may feel a little confusing for some people, so what I decided to do was creating another resource which could help you a lot in order to prepare yourself for this exam as well, which is comprised of many, many different notebooks you can use in order to practice, in order to have even more hands-on experience to prepare yourself for this exam. And the way these notebooks work is that they simulate exactly the same conditions you will have during the exam. Remember, I cannot give you the questions for this exam. I am not giving you the questions. I am giving you some notebooks with other questions which you can use in order to prepare yourself in order to take this exam. And let me show you how these notebooks work. Basically, you are going to have a question, a prompt, then you are also going to have a data set, and you will need to train a model. You will need to write your code here in order to train the model. The only thing you need to do is to fill in the blanks and to train this model. And then the most valuable and the most important part of this notebook is that at the end, you are going to have a function which simulates the way the grading works during the exam. Remember, you need to submit the model, and you're going to be graded based on the performance of that model on another dataset you have absolutely no access to. And this is exactly how this function works. You are going to build a model, and then you are going to submit this model, and you're going to test this model on another dataset which is completely different to the one you are going to to use in order to train the model, right? So this simulates exactly the same conditions you will have during the exam. So this is a resource I created, and I think it's going to help you a lot in order to gain more experience and to prepare yourself for this exam. And this is a resource which is available in my Patreon. This is available to all my Patreon supporters. So this is all I have to say about the TensorFlow Developer Certificate, and also I wish you the best of luck when you take the exam. I wish you to get certified as a TensorFlow developer, and I wish you to succeed in getting the certification. Then something else is that if you are interested in other machine learning certifications, I am currently studying for the AWS Certified Machine Learning Specialty, which is another very popular certification in machine learning. If by the time you're watching this video I have already passed this certification as well, I'm going to post another video telling you about how I prepare myself to pass this exam, and I'm going to post a link to this video over there. So this is going to be all for today. My name is Felipe, I'm a computer vision engineer. If you enjoyed this video, I invite you to click the like button, and I also invite you to subscribe to my channel. This is going to be all for today, and see you on my next video.